Stop allowing your small thinking cause you to doubt God's omnipotence. And here's why. Because your job is to only, and I mean only, focus on your why. Why do you want to develop and become a better person? Why do you want to get that prize job? Why do you want to start that business? Why do you want a better relationship or a better family? Why do you want to scale your company? The how, that's up to God. And believe me, he or she doesn't need any help. All you have to do is focus on your why. And I had to learn this oh so hard lesson. When I was growing up, my mother disowned me. Anything I did wasn't good enough. Anything I said wasn't good enough. I don't care how much I accomplished, I could not please her. Our relationship got so estranged that if I would walk in the house and see her, we would head nod, "What's up?" and keep it moving. This is unheard of, especially for a mother and her youngest child. But again, I had to play the game that she was playing, or else I may be dead today. I may not even be here, because it was that devastating to me. I went to college and I heard my friend talk about how much he missed his family, especially his mother. And he talked about how he couldn't wait to get home to see his mother. And then a light bulb went off and it made me realize that I too miss my mother, which I had totally isolated out of my mind. So I set up a meeting to talk to her to resolve these issues. And again, after I spilled my heart, came clean, finally thought we were gonna make some progress to fix our relationship, she looked me in the eyes and told me she never did any of those things, that she never said those things. And again, I was outraged. I was so angry. And that's when the voice, God, told me to forgive her. Now again, I was thinking about how can our relationship be fixed? That's where I was going wrong. See, never allow your small mind to make you doubt God's omnipotence. He told me to forgive her. So then I prayed for direction. I eventually had a release after I forgave her. I didn't see her for a few years, but we talked on the phone. But let me tell you what God did. Later on, she was diagnosed not only with schizophrenia, but with dementia. And see, I know that may sound bad and things, and I felt bad for her initially too, but let me tell you what it did. She forgot not only the pain that she experienced in life, but she forgot that she disowned me. She forgot that she wasn't supposed to like me. She forgot that she was supposed to continue to isolate me out of the family and make me feel abandoned or disowned. Now, our relationship is amazing. She still remembers me as her son, but she doesn't remember how much she's not supposed to like me. She don't remember any of those things. So here I was, questioning and doubting that this relationship could ever be better, that this relationship could ever get to the point that I love my mom and she loved me. And now look, God stepped in and fixed it like only God can. So my question to you is this: how many things are you trying to control with your mind? How many things are you trying to fix yourself? How many things are you trying to figure out how are you going to get it done? You're wasting your time and you're doubting God's omnipotence. Listen, let me tell you, relax, focus on your why, and trust God. It is a beautiful Friday. Hopefully you're having a great day, but I'm here to tell you, you were born to be great, and don't let anyone tell you otherwise. The game is not over until you win. Have a great Friday.